Welcome to Universal Forum. So in my today video, I am going to describe you about the power and velocity relation. In my previous video, I already described power and velocity relation, but in this video, I am giving you a little bit review of the power and velocity relation, and this is example. Okay, so let's start. A force thrust of 400 Newton is required to overcome road friction and air resistance in propelling an automobile at 80 km per hour. What power must the engine develop? So here you know that power, we can define the power in kilowatt. As we know that the unit of power is watt, which is represented as W. So let's start. First, I'm write down the given data. This is a force F equals to 400 Newton is required to overcome road friction, and this is the 80 km per hour. This is what is velocity. Okay, V equals to 80 km per hour. As we know that velocity is equals to distance over time, and what is the distance? Meter, and the unit of T is second. So here this is a kilometer and this is the per hour. Unit of velocity is meter per second. So now I'm going to convert the velocity into meter per second. Unit of velocity is meter per second in SI. That's why I'm going to convert velocity into meter per second. As we know that 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meter. So I'm going to multiply 80 into 1000. So it convert into the meter, and into per hour. As we know that 60 into 60 equals to hour. It's converted into the second. Okay, so 60 into 60 converts into the second. So 80,000, and this is 3600. This is the force and this is the velocity. And we can define the power into kilowatt. So what is the formula of power? If you want to go through the whole relation about the power and velocity, so you must review my previous video. If divide the 80,000 into 3600, we get 22.2 meter per second minus 1. As we know that the formula of power is P equals to F dot V. F is 400 Newton and velocity, which is 22.2 meter per second. By solving, P equals to 888 watt. As we know that we have the power in terms of kilowatt, so if I am moving the point is here, I am moving to 3, because 30 means kilo. So 1, 2, and 3, 0.888. so it's mean that it converted into 8.9 into 10 to power 3 kilowatt. So there is the power equals to the 8.9 into 10 to power 3 kilowatt. Video example of power and velocity relation. I will leave also link in description box of power and velocity relation description. So to like it, share and subscribe for more informative stuff. And in my next video, I'm going to describe about the dimensions of the power. So must watch that video.